So in today's video, I'm going to dive into some of what I think are the best hidden Easter eggs and lore filled commands in Linux history. These are some quirky gems that reveal the personality of Linux and Unix. Let's get started with some vintage command and see what kind of fun we can have at the terminal with these hidden Easter egg commands. So I'm going to cover these in date order, starting with the oldest, and that has to be fortune. Simply type in fortune, and what do you get? It's going to print a random joke, a quote, or a proverb with a mix of wisdom, humor, and absurdity. So look at this. Celebrate Hannibal Day this year, take an elephant to lunch. This was created in BSD Unix era to inject a bit of lighthearted personality into the command line. It's a daily reminder that systems and users could have character. Now let's talk about the yes command. That's it, yes. This repeats any given word endlessly. It was originally used to automate responses in scripts, and it can be mesmerizing. Back in Unix's early days, when to automate responses, yes was a simple but powerful way. It later found fame for stress testing and benchmarking CPUs due to its repetitive output. So I could type yes, and I could type, I love Linux. And then I'm going to hit enter, and what do I get? An endless stream of I love Linux. And the only way to make this stop is to control C. There we go. Now let's talk about the calendar command. This displays notable dates and events. It's a peek into history and quirky trivia. It was originally part of Unix efforts to add daily useful utilities, and it was intended for scheduling, but evolved to share historic dates and even humorous events. There we go, we get a bunch of stuff relating to October 28th and the 29th. So this is a quick calendar, shows notable dates, and is great for a bit of trivia or for some historic reminders. How about we summon a steam locomotive animation across the screen? The idea here, this was created by Toyoda Masashi as a joke. SL became an instant favorite for reminding users of typos with a bit of flair. If you accidentally type SL instead of LS, you're going to get this quirky command showing a steam locomotive going across the screen. Remember, you can even add an L flag if you want a long train or an M flag for steam. So let's add it now. SL, what do I get? A train coming across the screen. Doesn't get better than that already, does it? What an Easter egg. And it's still going. Nearly finished. The train is arriving at the station. Fantastic stuff. Now let's talk about Figlet. Figlet generates ASCII art from text, and it's perfect for headers or playful terminal art. So in Unix systems, it became popular for adding bold statements in scripts, headers, and announcements. So I could use the figlet command, pull it with a string, for instance, Linux rocks. I think it does. And there we go. We get a lovely header there. What an Easter egg. Now, here is a command you're going to love if you love Matrix. You want to get the iconic Matrix look? Just simply type in CMatrix, and look what happens next. You're going to get the rain of code like you see at the start of Matrix. Look at that. It's like I've created the movie myself. I think this is awesome. What a cool command. Simply type that in, and there you go. You get to enjoy the Matrix in your own terminal. Now, let's talk about Tetris, but not just any Tetris. This is Bastet Tetris. Yeah, we're going to use the Bastet command. And with the Bastet command, we can intentionally challenge a twist on normal Tetris, because this chooses the pieces you don't want, bringing a bit of masochistic fun to the terminal. Simply enter Bastet, and it takes Tetris and flips it on its head. I'm going to click that now, and there you go. I can play the normal hard version. Play normal, and as we see, I am now playing Tetris in my terminal. How amazing is that? Did you ever know that was there? Or what if you want to generate some random fake names and addresses? This is perfect for testing, and it was originally created as a simple testing tool. You simply use the rig command, and this will become a favorite generating humorous identities and filler data. There's nothing much more to it. I click rig, what do I get? Incredible. So if you want to generate quick fake names and addresses, rig is the way to go. How do you feel about having your terminal insult you when you get things wrong, okay? So how about using sudo in insult mode? It's going to deliver a humorous insult if you type an incorrect sudo password. This adds a little bit of lightning to the frustration of mistyping passwords. And it's a hidden gem for users who enjoy a bit of sass from their system. To do, you've got to open the sudoers file. So you go into that and you add default insults. So let's do that now. So sudo, yeah, sudo, and enter my password. And now I'm in this, and I've already added this. You can see this line here, default insults. You add that line, write out, save this file. Next time you enter your password incorrectly, you're going to get an insult from the terminal telling you to try harder, maybe need a refresher and basic typing. So I'll exit this now. I'm going to enter the incorrect password to show it insult me. So here we go. Gibberish. What do we get here? This mission is too important for me to allow you to jeopardize it. And this is what you're going to get. This isn't necessarily that insulting. It's more funny. I could try something else and see what it throws at me next. And now when you, okay. So as you can see, it's an incredible way to make using sudo more entertaining when you're at the terminal. I love this. Who doesn't want the terminal abusing you when you get your password wrong? I certainly do. Okay, rounding things off, how do you feel about streaming an ASCII animation of Star Wars Episode 4 directly to your terminal? Yeah, you can do it. Thanks to artist Simon Janssen, this ASCII masterpiece is hosted online for anyone to watch. It's becoming an iconic Linux Easter egg, in my opinion, and it's been loved by Star Wars fans and techies alike. And it's a really simple command. Obviously, you need telnet installed. You simply type in telnet, and then we're going to go to towel.blinkenlights.nl. I'm going to click enter for this. That sounds fine too. Enter again. Here we go, 20th century text, not Fox. This is all about text. Now, of course, I haven't got 2 hours and you probably didn't have 2 hours to spend watching this, but I encourage you to give this a try and you can watch Star Wars in your terminal. What an incredible way to do it. So let's let it run for a few seconds and see what we get. But if you've seen the film before, you'd be fully familiar with what's going on here. This is the infamous text going into space at the start of the movie. And of course, the longer you watch this, the more you'll be able to enjoy seeing the movie. And that's it. 10 hidden commands full of Linux lore and humor. From ASCII Star Wars to sassy insults, I think these Linux Easter eggs reveal the fun side of the command line. I really encourage you to give them a try and let us know which one's your favorite. Bear in mind that most of these won't be installed by default on your system. So when you try to run some of these commands, you might get an error. But oftentimes, if you're using Debian or Ubuntu, like I am, for instance, for this example, it will tell you what command to run to be able to install this package, and you'll be able to run the commands and have fun with them. So thanks so much for watching. I hope you enjoyed this one, and I can't wait to see you in the next one.